Recognize Representative Lee Zeldin of New York for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, and Madam Ambassador, congratulations on your selection, and welcome to the committee again. I wanted to ask, with regards to Golan Heights, what is the administration's position on recognizing Israeli sovereignty over it?
This is an issue that the administration is still working on. We're still pushing for a two-state solution that allows Israel to live in peace and security and recognizes its right to exist. And I know that in terms of the Golan Heights, that's something that is not yet on the agenda.
The prior administration recognized Israeli sovereignty over the Golan Heights. Has that changed?
We have not changed any of the decisions of the prior administration.
Sally Berisha was recently hit with sanctions. The reference made by the Biden administration was a charge of corruption, but I've been trying to find out additional information on what that corruption is. Is there anything else that you can add other than just the word corruption?
I'll have to get back to you on that one. It's not an issue I have any details on.
Okay. I asked the Secretary of State that question. He's the one who authorized it, and he said that I should follow up and send a letter, and I haven't gotten a response to the letter, and you're here, and I figured I'd ask, but no one in the Biden administration is able to add anything beyond just the word corruption.
I will convey your question back to the secretary again and follow up with you.
Thank you. And following up on something that Mr. Deutsch asked you about with regards to the UNRWA, the textbooks, what do you do? What steps can you take to make sure that the UN and UNRWA are actually making those changes to the textbooks? Because you inherited years of this back and forth of, the reports would come back that we're working with the UN, we're working with UNRWA, but it's still an issue many years later. What specifically can you do to, what's your leverage to make sure that happens?
In our re-engagement with UNRWA this time around, the Office of Population, Refugees, and Migration is drafted an MOU with all of the requirements that we have of UNRWA. And then again, this is something that we will be very, very closely monitoring. We have seen some evidence where UNRWA itself has monitored and found problematic terminology in books, and they brought that to our attention and moved it out of the school system. But we also have to push for the countries, because many of the textbooks are developed by the countries, and push these countries also to deal with unacceptable language in those textbooks. But we're going to be monitoring this even more closely than we've ever done before.
And something that has happened in the past is that there would be an English-only supplement that would have the more proper material in it, but the educators on the ground aren't using that English-only supplement. They're still using the textbook. And that's something that I just put on your radar is not being an acceptable response for them, is just adding some insert that's not going to actually get used. They have to actually get rid of the bad textbooks.
I agree with you, and we will follow up on that.
Thank you. Are there any UN peacekeeping operations at all? I mean, many have been going on for half a century. Are there any UN peacekeeping operations that you're identifying as needing to be winding down in any way or cut? I mean, it's a broad scope all across the entire world. Are you identifying any as a mission that's winding down or should be winding down?
We're reviewing them just for that purpose, and I'm actually proud that one UN mission that not only drew down but ended was the UN mission in Liberia. That was something that I worked very, very closely with the president of Liberia, with the UN special representative to address. And it was a very orderly process. And I think it's an example that other peacekeeping missions can use as they look at what is needed for them to draw down.
If you can provide that once you put that report together and you've finished your work, that would be an update I'm sure many on the committee would love. I yield back.